Hey everyone, welcome back to Google Developers Live. I'm Vic Frizell, and this is Nicolas Garnier. Today we're going to be talking about the Google Drive SDK and a new way to install your application, which we call the install scope. So just to give some background, when we first launched the Google Drive SDK, you had to install your application using the Chrome Web Store, and installation was required for an application to do anything with the Drive API. We've gotten a lot of feedback about that, and we've since changed things a little bit. So no longer is installation required for your app to work with the Drive API. It's just required for your app to show up in the Google Drive user interface. And we've also changed the installation mechanism a little bit. So you can still install your application from the Chrome Web Store, but we've added a new way for you to install your apps. So the install scope is essentially an Oauth 2.0 scope that you add when requesting an Oauth token. And if this token is granted to your application, if this token is approved by the user, then your application is automatically installed into the Google Drive user interface. So this is kind of an important distinction, because previously a user would have to go to the Chrome Web Store and click Add to Drive to install the application, but that's no longer the case. This allows installation of Drive applications from outside of the Chrome Web Store. Maybe in your own application, for instance. So today what we're going to do is go through how to use this scope, and we're going to show you like how an application gets installed into Drive.
Yeah. So with the new scope. So what would we like to start with?
Maybe we'll go through the documentation.
All right. So this is documentation. I hope you guys can see that on the screen. This is the new install scope here, which I'm highlighting. And which I'm trying to highlight, sorry. And you know, guys, if you're familiar with OS 2, you need to send the user to the grand screen, and the grand screen on the grand screen, sorry, you'll get a message depending on which scopes you're trying to get to approve the user to approve. And for that particular scope here, which we call the drive.install scope, the install scope, you'll get this little message. Which basically says, you know, my app, it should be the name of your application right there. Mm-hmm. My app is requesting permission to add itself to Google Drive and appear basically in the Google Drive Open With menu and appear in the Google Drive Create menu. So this is basically going to enable your app to appear on the user's menu inside Google Drive, which I can show you right now. I have a few applications installed. So this is my Drive. And as you can see here on the Create under More, I have a bunch of third-party applications that I have installed already, like Balsamic, like Pixel Editor, Lucidchart, etc. And also, if I think right-click on a file, sorry, whoop. And here I have a right-click. I left-clicked inside instead. Under Open With, for example, here I can with HelloFax open that Google document, and also with Zoho Writer. So enabling the install scope is basically going to add your application there, basically, right. On your Google Drive UI, mm-hmm. integrate your application inside the Google Drive UI of the user.
Yeah.
Do you like maybe to do you think we should demo that with the Oauth 2 Playground?
Sure, that sounds like a good idea.
So I don't know if you guys know the Oauth 2 Playground. The Oauth 2 Playground is a tool that lets you basically play with the Oauth 2 protocol and use the APIs, mostly Google APIs. I mean, we make it easy for Google APIs. Also work with third-party APIs. So it lets you play around with APIs and basically with the Oauth 2 protocol.
Yep.
So this is the interface of the Oauth 2 Playground. As you can see here, you can manually basically enter a scope that you want to basically authorize through Oauth 2. Since the drive.install scope is not listed on the default list that we have here, that is kind of convenient, you can simply write it down on that text box.
So to be clear, this is just copied and pasted from the documentation.
Yes, definitely.
Right. If you're writing a real application, you would request at least all three of these scopes. Mm-hmm. But here, we're just requesting only the install scope so that we can demonstrate installation only. This token that we get back actually won't be able to do anything with the Google Drive SDK outside of be installed, and that's significant. So in a real application, you would request the other scopes that we mentioned in the documentation.
Yeah. The drive.install scope only enables the UI integration. You don't get access to any data. So it's important to also ask for access to the to these other scopes, like the drive.file scope or the drive wide scope, basically. Yeah. So one really interesting feature about the Oauth 2 Playground is that it's actually a Google Drive application. If you install the Oauth 2 Playground on your drive, you'll get an option to open any file with the Oauth 2 Playground and basically play around with the API on that particular file, or also have the Oauth 2 Playground under the Create With menu. And basically here, if we're going to authorize the drive.install scope with the Oauth 2 Playground, what that's going to do is that's going to add the Oauth 2 Playground to my drive, basically install the Oauth 2 Playground to my drive. So basically enable the drive UI integration that the Oauth 2 Playground has implemented, basically.
So the first thing Nicola's going to do is click Authorize APIs. And this is going to spawn the Oauth flow. So when he clicks this, you see the screen here asking for the application to add itself to Google Drive, which is the exact same screen that's in the documentation here. So this is exactly what we're about to add. Oops. So when he clicks Allow Access, we're actually going to grant the token.
Yeah. So we get redirected back to the Oauth 2 Playground. So this redirect step was the first step of Oauth 2.0. If you're using the server-side flow, and also the client-side flow, actually. The second step, if you're using the server-side flow, is to exchange the Oauth code that we give you in the URL here. Yeah. You can see in the URL we, when the user gets redirected to your application here to the Oauth 2.0 Playground, now we simply have to exchange that code for tokens.
Yep.
So I'm simply going to click that button. And here we go. So we are getting access tokens and refresh tokens. Guys, I invite you to look it up if you want to learn more on the Oauth 2.0 protocol, which is the best way to authorize to use Drive APIs. Look it up if you have more questions. Here we're gonna basically focus on what enabling the drive.install scope, authorizing the drive.install scopes does to, how that adds the Oauth 2 Playground to your drive.
Yeah.
So all we had to do here is authorize the scope, basically, and nothing else. We can't use the scope and the token that was granted by the scope to actually access any data. What that does is now, if I go back to my drive and I refresh, here we go. Now if I right-click on the file in my Google Drive, I should have, if everything works right. See, the Oauth 2 Playground is now an option. So basically, the Oauth 2 Playground has been installed to my drive. The Oauth 2 Playground's UI, drive UI integration has been enabled on my drive. That's what authorizing the drive.install scope did. Mm-hmm. And now, I can use the Oauth 2 Playground like it was a drive app and perform operations on that particular file.
Yeah. So that what's important to note is the allow access screen that Nicola just got was for that one particular file, because his application had never opened that one file before, right? So we weren't requesting new access there. It was just access to that one file.
Well, since it was the first time we were using the Oauth 2 Playground from the Google Drive UI, you get that prompt, which you don't get in subsequent times. If we were not using the Oauth 2 Playground, we're using a real application, you would typically get that grant screen only the first time, and after you've authorized, the user has authorized access, and you've exchanged the Oauth code for tokens, the user will not see that grant screen anymore. Will simply go through directly to the application.
Yeah.
So maybe we should talk a little bit about what that improves. What was the former way to install applications? And
so this enables you to spawn an install flow from within an application. Here, the sample application we're using is the Oauth 2 Playground. But previously, this wasn't possible because all installation had to happen through the Chrome Web Store. So here, let's, for instance, take Lucidchart. If I come to Lucidchart and I click Add to Chrome, and I click Add, this is actually installing Lucidchart into Nicola's drive, which I think you had installed twice. And then if I come back here to Drive and I refresh, I should see create more Lucidchart diagram. So that installation required you to start with the Chrome Web Store. What this new install scope is going to allow Lucidchart to do is put an install button on their own page. So that if a user with Google Drive lands at Lucidchart's website, they can now allow installation right from there without having to redirect the user through the Chrome Web Store. So we still recommend that developers list in the Chrome Web Store for marketing reasons, but no longer is this directly attached to installation. So you can still install from the Chrome Web Store. I mean, that's fine. We haven't changed anything there. We've just tried to make things a little bit more scalable and easier for developers.
Yeah, we've added a feature. And one particular something very interesting here is that it makes it way easier for developers to get started.
Right.
In the past, you had to basically, to start developing that UI integration, you had to create first the Chrome Web Store listing, maybe a test Chrome Web Store listing, which takes a while. You know, you have to enter a bunch of images, assets. You have to prove that you're the owner of the website on the Chrome Web Store listing. And then you would be able, as a developer, to install your Chrome Web Store listing application and start developing, start building that Drive UI integration on your app.
Right.
Now, by authorizing a simple scope, which you have to do anyways, you have to authorize the other Drive scopes. You simply get the UI integration enabled, and you can start working from there. It's a really faster way to get started for developers and start coding.
Yeah, I think it shaved maybe 10 minutes off of the time to start coding.
Yeah, actually even more. I mean, I've created a bunch of Chrome Store listings. If you're not, you know, used to it and don't have the proper images of the exact right pixel size, it would take maybe half an hour or something like that to get started there. And now we're making it a lot easier. In 1 minute, you could even use the Oauth 2 Playground and enter your app's credentials and the install scope, click install, and boom, you would have your application installed on your Drive UI.
Yep. So a few other things about the install scope. If Nicola were to revoke the token that he granted here, the application would no longer be installed in the Drive user interface.
So revoking a token, there's a few ways to do that.
Yep.
The first way is to go to your Google Accounts page, and you have a way to view all the third-party applications that have access to some of your data. If you revoke the token there that has the drive.install scope authorized for, basically what that does is that uninstalls the application from your Drive UI. Mm-hmm.
Also, this allows third parties to do uninstall. So here, a Drive developer could also send a request to Google to revoke the token on the user's behalf. And given that, the application would uninstall itself from Google Drive. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit more scalable. Whereas otherwise, the user would have to go into the Google Drive UI and manage their applications to uninstall the app. So I think we can show that here. If I go to Settings and then Manage Apps, here are all of the apps that Nicola has installed. And I can remove any app on here and then just click OK. So that is pretty much it for the install scope. If you have any questions, find us on Stack Overflow. You can find the documentation at developers.google.com/drive/install. Mm-hmm. I'm Vic Frizell. This is Nicola Garnier. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.